मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई प्रशांत रंजन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच साइंस ऑफ क्लास 4। योर टॉपिक इज फोर्स वर्क एंड एनर्जी। फोर्स वर्क एंड एनर्जी, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू नो अबाउट दैट व्हाट इज फोर्स एंड द टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू फोर्स। फोर्स इट मींस यू कैन से दैट अ पुल और पुश दैट इज एक्टिंग ऑन अ बॉडी दैट कैन चेंज द शेप एंड साइज, as well as you can say that state of motion, as well as you say that direction of a moving object. It means force is a physical phenomenon that can change the state of rest, state of motion, shape and size, as well as you can say that the direction of the body, the moving direction of the body, it can change. The SI unit of force is Newton, and CDS unit of force is dyne. Now, uses of force. In this chapter, we have to learn about that force and its uses, energy and its source, different types of energy and work. The chapter is categorized into three subgroups: force, work and energy. Force, work and energy. Now, work, it means we can say that according to science, when we can say that work is done and when we can say that work is not done. According to science, work is only done when we applied a force on an object and it would displace from it places. It means the position of the object can change. It can displace from its position. Then we can say that according to science, work is done. Otherwise, if suppose a labor handling 50 kg of weight and standing at a position with respect to time, he cannot change its position with respect to time, then we can say that according to science, work is not done. Only work is done when we apply force on an object and it would be displaces from its position, then we can say that work is done. Suppose I apply 10 Newton force to the wall and it would not displaces from its position, then we can say that according to me, work is not done by me. According to science, work is not done by me. So we can say that if we applied unbalanced force on an object and it would displaces from an from its position, then we can say that work is done. Now talking towards the another topic, energy. Energy, it means ability, capacity, capability. You have to do a work. The capacity that is present inside you to perform a work. It means we can say that energy, it means ability to do work. Suppose I am here and I am teaching you by e-learning classes and I need a energy to speak. This energy comes from food. The food that I take, the energy should be given by the food, by digestion, when it digested in the body, then the energy is provided to the each and every part of the body, then the body would perform their work. It means the ability to teach is comes from the energy, and it means the energy is the you can say that energy, it means the capacity, capability and the ability that is inside you to perform any work, to perform any task. Now we can see the learning plan of this chapter, force and its uses, concept of work and energy. Force, it means we can say that force can change the shape and size of an object. Force can move a stationary object. Force can stop a moving object. Force can change the direction of a moving object. Now you can say how the force can change the direction of a moving object. For how we can say that force can change the direction of a moving object, by taking an example we can consider that force can change the direction of an object. Suppose in cricket you would see that when a bowler apply a force on the ball and batsman hits the ball in batsman exert force on the ball and hit the ball, then the ball goes to the another direction. It means we can say that force can change the direction of an object. Just like that, force can stop a moving object. When we apply force on an object, it would be stop. It means we can say that force can stop a moving object. Now talking towards the another topic, that is the force can move a stationary object. Suppose when you placed a football on the ground and when you apply a force, suppose when you kick the football, you applied a force on the football and football start moving. It means we can say that by force have different uses. By the help of force, we can do our different work. So we can say that force is an important phenomenon of our life. We use force to do our daily work. Now talking towards the another things, that is the types of force. There are different types of force, just like the muscular force, frictional force, magnetic force, gravitational force. Now turning to the muscular force, it means the force that is generated by the muscles of our body. It means we generate a force, the force generating by us, our muscles, is known as the muscular force to do different types of work. Talking to as the frictional force, it means when you, suppose you are walking on the road, you are walking on your, at your home, you walk, you can write on the paper, I can write on the board. This all happens due to a force that is known as the frictional force. Frictional force, it means the force which opposes the motion of an object. It means we can say that if the direction of the force is that, and a frictional force is what? It always acts in the opposite direction of an object, of a moving object. It means suppose a body moves from A to B, then the direction of frictional force is B to A. It means we can say that frictional force always opposes the motion of an object. It means we can write due to the frictional force. I am writing here on the board due to the frictional force. You can walk due to the frictional force. Tires, grooves and are provided in the tires to provide a frictional force. That's why a vehicle can move on the road. So we can say that due to the frictional force, different types of work is prescribed by us. And now talking towards the another thing, that is the magnetic force. Magnetic force, it means we can say that the force that is generated by the magnet to attract the magnetic substances. Magnetic substances, it means what? Magnetic substances, we can say that the substances that is made up of iron, nickel or cobalt, it means they can be attracted by the magnets. Magnet can exert a force that is known as the magnetic force. And magnetic force can attract the object that is made up of iron, nickel and cobalt. Now talking towards the another types of force, that is the gravitational force. Gravitational force, it means we can say that the force that is generated by the heavenly or celestial body to attract anything towards its center. It means we can say that a force through which all the heavenly body exert to attract each and everything towards its center, and the force is known as the gravitational force. And the force that is generated by the earth to attract anything towards its center is known as the gravity of the earth. So we can study here the types of force, the different types of force. Now talking towards the another topic of this chapter, that is the work. Work, I have already told you that work, it means when we applied force on an object and it would be displaces from its position, then we say that according to science, work is done. It means When we apply a force on an object and it would displaces from its position, then we can say that according to science, work is done and the SI unit of work is joule. Now talking about the another topic, that is the energy. Energy, it means the capacity that is inside you, the ability that is inside you, the capacity, capability and ability to perform your work is known as the energy. Energy are categorized into different subgroups. That is the and we have to also you are doing a different types of work at your home and you already need energy to do the type of work. So we can say that energy is need to perform your work. It is the capacity, it is your ability that is present in you. Now today our chapter is mostly completed. Rest of the topic, the types of energy and the uses of force, is completed in the next lecture. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Have a nice day.